Children, we see that the environment consists of biotic and abiotic components. Now, what are biotic components? A biotic component is a world of living organism where life is there. And there are two types of plant kingdom and animal kingdom. Now, we also come under that. Okay. And what are abiotic? They are non-living elements. Which are the non-living elements? Sun, water, land, rocks, all these come under abiotic components. You can see here the biotic components of environment are plant, trees, animals, birds, insects, humans, and abiotic is air, water, soil, sunlight, weather. All these form the components of the environment. Environment consists of both living and non-living. Biotic is living and abiotic is non-living components. So children, we have learnt about the natural environment components. You can see here water, air, land and living things which forms the biosphere. Now we come to the next component of the environment is human made. Now human made makes many things. What does he make? He makes buildings, parks, bridges, roads, monuments, industries. Isn't it? According to his needs, he makes it. He has learned to domesticate animals, learned to grow crops, invented the wheel, started trade and commerce, transportation, internet. The latest thing is the internet. Okay, where we communicate, and just at the press of a button. So all these things have come under human made. Humans, with all their knowledge and skills, they make all these things for their own needs. Okay, and this is the way they change the environment. Children, the next component of the environment is human environment. Now who are humans? They are us. Okay, and we are also a part of a family, we are part of a community at large, then we are part of a religious group, then we go to school, then we also do trade and business. When we grow up, we earn money for ourselves, we are also part of the political system of our country. Okay, so we do all these work as humans. Okay, so that comes under new component of environment is human environment. Okay, so we have learned three components. What were the three components? You can see here natural, human made and human components. Okay, under human components we are doing all this as an individual. We work together as a family, as a community. We are all divided on the religious basis, and we get educated, earn money, and also we are part of the functioning of the country. Isn't it? We all have the right to vote. So we are a part of the functioning of the government also. Children, now we will go ahead and learn what is ecosystem. Now let me give you the definition. It is a community or group of living organisms that live in and interact with each other in a specific environment. Okay. So this definition is of ecosystem, but I think it is very confusing for you. Now let me explain it a little better. Children, ecosystem is a harmonious mix of natural environment and human environment. Okay, the survival of biotic components depends on the interaction with abiotic components. Isn't it? So you can see plants cannot survive without air, water, soil. So the biotic components depend on the interaction with other biotic or abiotic components. Okay, animals depend on trees, and then trees depend on the abiotic component. Have you understood this? Now let me explain to you about ecosystem in further detail. Children, you see here it is a jungle. You can see the jungle here, which is surrounded by trees and plants all around. And then you can see wildlife roaming around in open space. Yes. And then you can see in the jungle there is a flower growing. You can see the flower growing with the help of the various nutrients. How does it grow? It gets the soil. From the soil it gets water. And from the atmosphere it gets carbon dioxide. And then it gets sunlight from the sun, and which converts into energy, the process of photosynthesis. Isn't it? and it can only blossom when sunlight shines and gives the energy to perform photosynthesis. So you can see the flower in full bloom when it gets all the three nutrients. Now what are the three nutrients? They are abiotic components. Now you children, you see, in order to survive, the deer eats the flower or the plant to consume the energy and nutrients which are stored in them. Okay, and then the deer lives for a long time and lives a happy life, but over the year the deer starts to slow down due to old age and then he dies. Okay, and the deer body rots and decomposes. Now the microorganisms found in soil decomposes the body and absorbs all the nutrients and energy it has. Okay, children, in this cycle you see that the deer eats the plant to consume nutrients for energy, and similarly we see that the flower is born again by consuming the nutrients from the dead deer, isn't it? Its microorganism gets into the soil. So do you think the flower or the deer could survive without each other? No, certainly not. Okay, and then we see here both the flower and the deer are biotic components of nature, and the interaction between these two biotic components helps them to survive. In the same way, the flower blossoms with the help of abiotic components like air, water, soil, sunlight and weather. Okay, that helps it to grow and blossom. Now these interactions between various biotic components or biotic with abiotic components create an ecosystem. So you see children, these interactions between various biotic components, okay, or between biotic and abiotic components create an ecosystem. So now what can we say? What is an ecosystem? All plants, animals and human beings depend on the immediate surroundings. They are interdependent on each other. They interact with each other in a specific environment. So that is ecosystem. With this we end the chapter. I hope it has been useful for you.